there will usually be some sort of presentation, some sort of marking in the office of the individuals leaving. That hasn't happened in the office, so we're doing one out here. Ian's worked for ICL stroke Fujitsu for 30 years. He's been a rep for 26 years. And he's, if you look around you, this is the number of people Ian has helped and assisted over the years. It's just a small sample of those people. In part because of Ian's dismissal and other people's unfair dismissal, as you're probably aware, we've the employees here and members here have voted to take part in industrial action, which will be starting shortly. And this dispute is in part to defend Ian. As I say, Ian has helped me in the Jigs and ICL for a great many years. But I also think we need to recognise the fact he has helped people and taken a very active part in the wider trade union movement for a great many years. Just to reflect that, I'm just going to ask one or two marketing people to make Ian's contribution outside. Firstly, I'd like to ask Eleanor Marmer. To say a few words.
Thank you very much. It's really good, but it's also really bad to be here today. It's absolutely disgusting what's happened to Ian. We're here, Ian, Janet and I, the Greater Manchester Hazard Centre, from the National Hazards Campaign, to support you in solidarity with you, solidarity with all the reps and all the union members and the workers here today. And we really want to pay tribute to you, Ian, as for all you have done. Trade unionism here at Fujitsu, for all you've done to support people, for all you've done in terms of organising and campaigning, and for what you've done in the wider trade union movement throughout Greater Manchester and the North West and nationally. And you've always given us masses and masses of support, and you've always been a very strong voice in terms of workers organising, not just for better wages, but for better health and safety, for workers' lives. You've always made it very clear. Good working conditions for workers is at the centre of decent lives for everybody. And I'd like to thank you very much, Ian, and to say that we are going to support you. We are furious as hell with the way you have been treated, and we will support the Fujitsu Unite members and all the workers here. And thank you, Ian, for what you have done. You are the best of trade unions. Unite members, you are the best.
Good afternoon, everybody. We're from Mears, just up the road at Emden Vale. This is our second dispute we're on. During the summer when we were out, a lone figure came wandering up the Vale Road with a load of barbecue stuff, sausages, bacon, barn cakes. Started off a barbecue in the morning for the lads. Don't sound like much, but nobody had come near us. Nobody wanted to know us. Since then, he has given us so much information, joined our Facebook group, kept in touch with us all the way along. We attended a socialist meeting in town that he informed us of. We've attended meetings. He's always been available to give us information, sometimes more than we've had from Unite itself. Today, we're here to give you some support, the same as you gave us, and to let you know that when we are up there, and if we go back in, some of us will still be coming down to support this lad. Because if you back us, we back you. The same as it should be in the union. We should all be backing each other, supporting each other, and standing in solidarity. Because if this people get away with sacking the reps, Mears will certainly try it. So it could be me, brother Colin here stood with you one day, the three of us taking him on. That'll be a battle. Thanks very much, everyone.
Ian would like to say a few words.
Firstly, just thank you so much, everyone, for coming. It's really appreciated. It's so strange leaving that building after all these years. It really is. I think part of the reason the reps wanted to organise this, and I have to say, it's actually thanks to the Mears strikers that were having the event, because they got in touch saying they were turning up. The Jiu-Jitsu reps thought, oh, we'd better do something then. But, you know, really thank you to everyone that's come. But I think it's worth remembering that I'm the fourth of the six members who've been fighting to stay who Fujitsu have dismissed. And it's absolutely disgraceful if you go through what they've done with those people. So the first two that were dismissed, there were vacant jobs in their own department the day they were dismissed. And they dismissed them anyway. One of them was dismissed, breaking our agreements, when she had an outstanding grievance over sexual harassment that she said was connected with her selection for redundancy. Now, all over the media, we're hearing about different organisations trying to clean up their act about sexual harassment that goes on in pretty much every workplace. And it shouldn't be going on, but it has been going on. And here you've got an individual that makes a complaint, and Fujitsu, that likes to brag about its commitment to diversity and inclusion, doesn't even investigate it before dismissing it. Absolutely disgusting. And then the third person gets, on Thursday the 28th of December, gets a letter telling them that he's going to be dismissed on Sunday the 31st of December, New Year's Eve. You know, and this is a company, people who work here will have seen the announcement that came out from John Vickerman, the HR director, that said they had tried to mitigate the impact of these unfortunate redundancies on the employees. Mitigate my arse. No, they really are not doing even the basic things. Then you look at me. Monday and Tuesday this week, I was on compassionate leave for a family funeral when I get the letter telling me that I'm being dismissed today. Some compassion, that is. It's absolutely disgusting the way that Fujitsu is treating people, and that's why I think it's so important that you're all here, because what they're doing to me today isn't about me. Right? It's not about my job. You know, they faked my redundancy. Some people got caught up in that as collateral damage, but they were willing to dismiss people in order to get me. It's not the first time they've tried. But they're doing that for a reason. They're doing that because they want to find it easier to push through bad changes, other job cuts, bad pay, bad treatment, to get away with sexual harassment, all the other issues that people are trying to tackle. They want to try and weaken the union in order to push that stuff through. And that's why, you know, the ballot we just had, I think it was magnificent that members voted for Action. A difficult ballot, you know, done over Christmas with the new trade union act requiring a high turnout. So, you know, really well done to everyone that that did return their ballot paper and voted for Action. Now, I don't know whether that action will be enough to get me back in that building, to get me reinstated. What I do know, though, is that we can make absolutely sure that Fujitsu think this was a really bad idea, and that they're going to think at least twice before they touch any other rep and hopefully any other member in the way that they've treated me. Because when those attacks come over the next year, everybody knows this isn't going to be the end of the job losses that Fujitsu has planned. They've made that clear. There's other people at risk today still trying to avoid redundancy and try and make sure their jobs are safe. We also know on the other side of the coin, the company accounts say that the company's expecting a settlement to the NHS contract that fell through some years ago. People who were here a while will remember that we all got no pay rise, got our bonus withdrawn that year because of this terrible news that the NHS contract had fallen through. And if the press are to be believed, and sometimes they might be, Fujitsu and the NHS have been suing each other for £700 million ever since, and they're expecting an outcome to that this financial year. And you wonder why perhaps they wouldn't want the strong union in place at a time when they're trying to push through cuts, offshore jobs, when they're going to get a windfall, presumably,
out of that legal action. And I think that makes it important. Whatever happens to me, it's for the people who stay in Fujitsu, whether I'm there or not, to make sure you fight and you have a strong union, that you can make sure that nobody's treated in the way the company have already treated four people and are trying to treat other people in the future. So keep that fight up. And as I said, some of you will have got my little leaving message yesterday. It's not a goodbye. And Fujitsu should certainly expect the unexpected.
Close minute get together. Thank you very much. At very short notice, all of you coming along. It really is appreciated. I'm sure we'll see you
Sunday.
We will see you in coming days, weeks, and months. In particular, can I raise your attention? There's a fundraiser for the Mears dispute Sunday. 2 o'clock. You'll have to remind me of the details.
It's at the White House Club, which is just by Parkervale Petrolink Station. It's a fundraiser for the Mears strike, but certainly I'd like to have a good lot of you as well, so hopefully you can come along.
Thank you. Also, it's been announced that the first strike day here will be Wednesday the 24th of January. So we'll certainly be here in the morning up till 10 o'clock. So if you want to pop down and say hello, it'd be really nice to see you there. So if you can all get together for some photos, please. I know we've been taking some already.